Yeah, look, I'm Jeff Rowe, the regatta director. The secret of running a good regatta here is in the volunteers. Anyway, putting this regatta together this year has been terrific. It takes you around all of the Hobart clubs and you just meet so many people, and I think that's one of the benefits of doing this job. And it's just a great event and a great day, and so many people seem to have a good time. So I just hope it just continues and let's get bigger and bigger.
Volunteer club, and we have a policy of trying to keep our fees as low as possible and really try and help kids in that might otherwise not get to have a go at sailing. So that's our role, to make sailing accessible to everybody, every child who wants to have a go. You have to be quite self-sufficient when you're out in the water. You have to be prepared to cope with changing weather conditions. You're in a boat with other people, so you have to communicate with other kids. So I think there's a whole lot to do with self-sufficiency. I guess any outdoor activity, outdoor pursuit stuff, does that a big lot of that, and sailing is particularly like that. I think it sets you up really well for life.
There were boats that sailed past the finish yesterday, fast little sports boat that had relatively young, and I'd say probably 17, 18 year olds sailing down, so which was great to see. And there's boats that, oh, I'm quite sure they were close to 90 when some of the boats come in as well, sailing equally as aggressively. So
very broad range.
It's a real range. We've got the likes of Gretel, which is an ex-America's Cup boat. We've got Tilt, which is a large sort of super yacht, very lightweight and fast boat. We've got some quite old
We have a separate classics division that races across both Division 1 and Division 2, so boats that have been designed before the 1960s. And we've also got One Designs, Etchells classes.
Yes. Yeah, I think we've now got the largest class of Etchells in Tasmania. So I think we have 7 at the moment, coming up to 9 shortly.
The thousands and thousands of hours that goes into making this all happen by our volunteers, who are just simply extraordinary. And such it is that we've actually got people that have arrived here from overseas. Yep. They've seen what's going on. They said, oh, we'd like to help. We'll volunteer for that.
So when we were coming back to Tasmania again, and home is nominally Cairns and North Queensland, we thought, what the heck, let's go back to the Cygnet Regatta. So we came down and said, does anybody need a hand? And here we are, water taxi drivers for the day, just being part of it. You know, we used to race boats up in Cairns when we lived there, so it's nice to be able to help out another club. It's a lovely, vibrant club with lots of volunteers, but there's always room for a few more, I guess, and they're very welcoming, so it's great.